Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. So before we start with today's episode and we're going to analyze the Bitcoin price, I have a small announcement to make. Bybit is currently starting here a new competition. It's called the WSOT. It's the World Series of Trading. So if you're interested in that, you find in my Twitter account all the information that you need if you want to sign up, because maybe it's going to be interesting for you. Also, if you want to participate on that competition, you can win and get some early bird bonus right now. Also, some welcome rewards as well and some other stuff. Maybe you're interested in that because the prize pool here is 150 Bitcoin, and there is also like a solo throwdown in case that you are going to trade alone or not, because I still have to inform myself what's going on here and what are the rules. But it looks like that you can trade for your own and get up to 300,000 in Tether, or you can trade with a troop and there you can get up to 150 Bitcoins. And I have put everything on the Twitter account, so you can go down below here into the video description and you can follow me here on Twitter. Here is my name over there. I have retweeted everything here what is important and relevant for this competition. And it looks like that you can also upvote here a troop captain. So if you want, you can also retweet and put my name in here. So maybe I'm gonna get selected as a troop leader and we can make a team up to trade together. Otherwise, you can also, of course, participate alone. Just go there where it says subscription, and then you can be one of the first one that register here to this competition. And you just have to click here if you already have a Bybit account and you're in. If you don't have a Bybit account yet, then you find also the sign up link down below here in the video description. Bybit, where it says Bybit here, you just click it and register. No need for KYC, nothing, just email and you're immediately signed up. And yeah, if you use my link, you can get some sign up bonus and also support the channel, and you can participate on this World Series of Trading competition that is coming up. I still didn't read everything, but it looks like that it's going to be something similar like the last trading competition that we had like a year ago. You also have less fees during this period, and you can also get some extra rewards and also this WSOT swag bag. So if you're interested in that, then go down below here in the video description, sign up to Bybit, and also use the links that you find in my Twitter account to register completely for free. And then we can trade as a team here. We can participate if you want as a team, or also if you want to trade alone, you can also do that solo. So go ahead and register to it if you're interested. But now let's get started with our TA, because Bitcoin currently is having this little retracement that I was waiting for yesterday. Shout out to all the people also on Discord. We have discussed to maybe close our long position. Some of you I know already closed like me. So right now I'm also looking for a new entry, so for new long positions, because currently I'm waiting for a confirmation that the old resistance is new support. And it also looks like that Bitcoin currently have this little nice retracement back down to possible test this $9,200 to $9,250. And there is where I'm gonna scale in some more longs over on Bybit. Here I'm maybe gonna open a bigger position, only up to 10x, and on BTR I already have a 40x high leveraged trade ready here with an entry of 9,250 to re-enter in here. On Bybit I'm gonna do the bigger trade, but there I want first to have the confirmation and see that we're gonna hold here this $9,200 area. Because here in the 1 hour, it also looks like that we're coming down here. We're cooling off here, the stochastic and RSI. We are currently trading below the 50 level, but I think most likely we're gonna come back up here pretty soon in the 1 hour. Maybe in the next couple of hours, we're gonna see this retest of 9,200 and then have the bounce back up. Also, if we do a small Fibonacci retracement here, more or less from the bottom here of this 9,100 to the top that we had currently at 9,440, you can see that the 0.618 Fib line is down here at around 9,250. So most likely we are gonna retrace somewhere there, and that's why I have also set here this limit order and on Bybit, probably gonna go a market in if we're gonna test here this area down here and we're gonna see a bounce. In case that we're starting to consolidate down here at 9,200 to 9,150, I'm gonna scale in some limit orders, because usually limit orders are always better than market orders. You pay way less fees. That's why always, if you can, try to get with a limit order into your trade. But currently everything is still looking very bullish here. If you go into the Bollinger Band, it looks like that we could have here an overshoot to the downside. Also MACD shifted to the downside. And if we go over to the 4 hour time frame, here you can see that currently we're trading above the 20 moving average, and also the 20 is now above the 200, which is a good sign. I'm waiting here also the 50 to come above the 200 in order to have the momentum again shifted to the upside, and we should see here pretty soon another retest of this $9,500 resistance. Stochastic and RSI is coming down, so this is good that we are cooling off. Important that we are not closing candles here in the 4 hour time frame below these moving averages here, otherwise it can get very dangerous and we could see a possible breakout here to the downside and losing also 9k. And let's also have a look here in the 4 hour in the Bollinger Band, because also here after overshooting it to the upside, we are retracing back down here. So my target is here to reach the 9,240 level, the middle line of the Bollinger Band, and there have a bounce to the upside. In case that we're gonna close a 4 hour candle below 9,240, then watch out for a possible dump towards the 9K again. Because if we're starting to trade again in the lower area, then this could be dangerous. And what we have seen yesterday could be a fake out, but so far everything is still okay and we're trading here on the bullish side. The top currently is at 9,420. MACD still shifted to the upside, and also if we have a look on the S&P 500 mini futures, you can see that yesterday we came right at the top of our rising wedge, and currently we are testing here the bottom. So in case that you're going to see also here the S&P mini futures go below 3,230, that could signal a possible play out of this rising wedge, and the target would be somewhere down here of around 3,130, so $100 less. And if we're gonna see a little crash like this, most likely also on Bitcoin we're gonna see something similar. So watch out also for the S&P 500 mini futures. If you see that there we're gonna have a major dump and the play out of this rising wedge, and most likely also on Bitcoin we're gonna see something similar, and a possible retest of 9K is coming up. So watch out for that scenario. But currently we're still trading on the bullish side. So far it looks like that we are gearing up for the next move to the upside, and that's why I'm also gonna start to scale in some longs to play it out, because the target is still $10,000 and we still didn't reach it. So this could be just a little retracement. Only if we're starting to close 4 hour candles below these moving averages and also below 9K, then it could be dangerous, because in that case we could see the bearish target towards $8,500. But so far, as I told you, everything is still good. The last thing what we have to see is if we're gonna have this last confirmation that now the 20 daily moving average is holding as a support. Yesterday we had a successful close above the 20 and 50 daily moving average, and currently it looks like that we are coming down to retest this area and hopefully also bounce from it. So I'm already now gonna scale in some long positions, but in case that today we're gonna close again below the 20 daily moving average, so below 9,250, then this could signal that maybe this was just a fake out and we're possibly gonna see another crash here into this falling wedge that we were in before. And then I'm expecting also a possible retest and hopefully also a bounce here from the 200 daily moving average at 8,580 currently. RSI successfully recovered above the 50, and also stochastic shifted now to the upside. So here we are back into bull mode. But as I told you, maybe wait for this confirmation that we're having now the 20 daily as a support. Yesterday we closed bullish, and right now we have to wait for this confirmation. You can already put in your trades right now, but in case that we're gonna crash again below the 20 daily and also close the daily candle below, then maybe consider to put a stop loss right below $9,100, or possibly even close your trade, because in that case this could be just a fake out and we will still see some price movements to the downside before a potential retest of $10,000. And also if we open up the Bollinger Band in the daily, you can see that we topped out right here at the top of the Bollinger Band at $9,400, and currently we are retracing back here into the midline. So this retracement, it is healthy, and this is most likely the best opportunity right now to buy some more cheap bitcoins and also to scale in some longs if you think that we are gonna go towards 10k from here on. And this is what I also think, because currently it looks like that we still have some more bullish and bearish momentum coming up, and all the MACDs here shifted to the upside. So if the daily candle today is closing above 9,220, we should be good to go for our 10k retest. And that's why if you want to play out this trade, then put your trade right now in and watch out for today's close. So with that said, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. Don't forget to sign up also to our $10 worth of Bitcoin weekly giveaway that is coming up every week. The video where you can subscribe to it is popping up at the end of this video where it says subscription video. I'm gonna select the winner of this giveaway at the end of the week. So make sure to subscribe here to the channel, leave a like, participate on the $10 worth of Bitcoin. And if you still need an account over on Bybit, Femix, BTR, or PrimeXBT, where you can trade Bitcoin and other assets up to 100x leverage, you find all the sign up links down below here in the video description. You support the channel, and also you can get some sign up boni. And if you have Twitch, you can also follow me on the live streams over there. The link to my channel you find also down below here in the video description. And if you have Discord, feel free to join our free trading chat. The link is also down below here. It's completely for free. Everyone is welcome. Thank you very much for watching, my friends, and we see us all in the next one. Bye.